Track tuned and ready to rumble, the ZL1 is king of the muscle cars, earning a 10 Best Cars award for 2018. Both the coupe and the convertible house a ferocious 650 horsepower supercharged 6.2-liter V8 donated by the Corvette Z06. Power is sent to the rear through either a 6-speed manual or a 10-speed automatic and an electronic limited slip differential, then scorches the pavement via ultra-wide rear tires. An 8.0-inch infotainment display is standard, a performance data recorder is optional. General Motors must have authorized overtime for its performance in badge-making departments over the past few years. Witness the sustained, affordable excellence of all those SS, 1L, Z51, Z06, Z07, ZR1, ZL1. And Cadillac V-Series models the corporation keeps cranking out. Now comes a car that combines two of those GM speak codes, ZL1 and 1L, but the sticker price doesn't seem to cover the sum of the parts. The ZL1 1-liter E-enhancements stretch the Camaro's performance envelope like a balloon ready to pop. Never mind the Corvette Z06-derived LT4 supercharged 6.2-liter V8 that is good for 650 horsepower and 650 pound-feet of torque, or the functional carbon fiber wing, a first for GM production cars, designed in a Formula One wind tunnel. The wing has the same effect as 300 pounds of lead ballast at 150 miles per hour, or the gaping front end that swallows 106 cubic feet more air per minute than a regular ZL1 at 87 miles per hour, or the chin splitter and dive planes on the cheeks. Instead, for just a moment, fixate on our measurement of the Camaro's maximum lateral acceleration, 1.18 grams. That kind of steady-state grip puts the 1L in an elite group. Indeed, there's only one car we've measured with more shtick, and that's the Corvette Z06 equipped with the Z07 package, 1.19 grams. If everything else lets go sooner, period. This Super Camaro will also bring its 3,842 pounds to a halt from the 70 miles per hour and 141 feet, besting the 3,710 pound Ford Mustang Shelby GT350R by 5 feet. To make the 1L's chassis this capable, GM had partners. Goodyear supplies the Eagle F1 Supercar 3R rubber, and this is the first car to wear these. Legal track meets here in size 305/30 ZR19, front, and 325/30 ZR19, rear. They wrap around forged aluminum wheels that are 1 inch smaller in diameter and thus, along with the tires, save a total of 13 pounds in precious rotating inertia and unsprung mass compared with the ZL1. All these settings allow owners to fine-tune their cars to their home tracks. At Area 27, a 3.0-mile circuit in British Columbia designed by Jacques Villeneuve, we ran 40-plus laps in the 1L. It was the iron rotor brakes, which carry over from the regular ZL1, and not the tires that kept us from turning more than 5 hot laps at a time. The pedal gets a little long on the 5th lap. Even so, few cars feel as shiftable while braking in corners as the 1L. Throw a downshift in there, and the car never gets unsettled. In corners, the tires claw for grip like a cat scurrying up a tree. Where you expect understeer, you get a neutral car, and too much throttle on exit causes the rear end to step out, either gently if you finesse it or aggressively if you're being deliberately foolish. This Camaro will do a 0-60 mph run in 3.5 seconds, all in first gear, mind you, with the 8-piece band blaring a Motown anthem. An 11.7-second quarter mile at 124 miles per hour is in the jukebox, too. That's just a couple tenths of a second off the ZL1 automatic's time. Some of the swiftness is a dividend of the 62 pounds saved, manual to manual, by the 1L conversion, though it isn't quite enough to make up for the better and quicker shifting of the roughly 100-pound heavier automatic. While the chassis mods make for a fantastic track car, The one-less ride is a little jarring for daily use as its springs are three times stiffer than those of the ZL1. Matt Grace, Camaro's performance variant manager, admits that he wanted to make the car a bit more extreme by ditching the trunk lining, for example. But he was thwarted by GM product planners mindful of history, who desired a one-liter that was true to its Gen 3 Camaro roots as an add-on to the existing equipment, not a give-and-take option. Unlike the Gen 5 Z/28, this one-liter has all the features of the ZL1, including heated and ventilated front seats, a heated steering wheel, and an 8.0-inch infotainment display. One thing you won't see in a ZL1 1-liter is an automatic transmission. The manual box is identical to the ZL1 6-speed except for a shorter 6th gear, 0.68:1 versus 0.54:1. There are only a few tracks this side of Bonneville that even need 6th, and one of those is the Nürburgring Nordschleife, where a ZL1 1-liter e-turned a lap in just over 7 minutes and 16 seconds, more than 20 seconds quicker than the Z/28 and 13 quicker than the Gen 6 automatic equipped ZL1. That ring time puts the ZL1 1-liter e in the company of virtual vaporware like the Gumpert, the Radical, and the Donkervoort. Yes, that's a car company. The best part of this package is its asking price. $71,295. Nearly everything else at this performance tier is 2 to 3 times pricier. The next closest performer is, surprise, a Z06 with the Z07 package, but it's still $20,000 more expensive. Chevy hasn't just made performance strides, it's made performance per dollar strides, too. Just don't tell the accounting department it can charge a lot more for this track animal.